Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Praise God. Somebody shout, yeah. All right, all right. Welcome to Dallas First Church. We're glad you're in the house. I want everybody to lean forward just a little bit. Put your hands out in front of you. Start shaking your hands. If you're new here, you don't know what we're doing. But just hang on, you're going to enjoy it. And now when I count to three, you're going to take those. But now, first of all, you got to get your eyes wide. You got to get a big old smile on your face. And when I count to three, throw your hands high in the air and shout, yeah. You ready? One, two, three. Whoa. They slipped up on me and put something where I'll walk on me. Lord, you got to watch the devil. He'll come up behind you. He'll put something in your way. You just got to keep on going. You just got to keep stepping up. Hallelujah. 6 weeks ago in 3 days, they tried to take me out. That lady turned in front of me. I was in that big old F-450 truck, and it totaled my truck out. The firemen that arrived there told me, they said, "Preacher, we knew you were dead, but look at you. You're walking away from it." In the last 6 weeks, the washing machine went out. The air conditioner. Now the sound. Who's shooting at me? At the house, the air conditioner went totally out. They said it shot. You got to have a new one. Dishwasher went out. Washing machine went out. What you going to do? My wife said, "I'm tired of all this." Yesterday I had a Brother Jason Watts. Brother Jason Watts. Brother Jason Yates. Was working at my house moving some dead trees off the pond. And when he hit one, it was tied to another with vines and pulled it down right on his head. He's all right. Come out all right. They did all the x-rays, scans. Everything's fine. He's a little stiff, a little sore. His wife's here. His kids are somewhere around here. Oh, where's the boy? There they are. Yeah. So they're here. He's probably watching. God bless you. And I told my wife, she said, "I'm tired of this." I said, "I am too. I tell you what, let's count it up. Yeah, it totaled the truck, but I lived. The lady that hit me, she's all right. I got a new truck. Better than the old truck. They gave me for that wrecked truck $1,500 less than what I paid for it. You don't find that. I was able to buy the new truck, and my payments are $250 less than the old truck. I got more on that new truck. Moonroof. Oh, Lord, have mercy. Here we go, folks. The washing machine. Out with the old, in with the new. It was about $300. Brand new. Here we are. Come on, somebody. Dishwashers. Here we go. Now the air conditioner, they gave me a deal. We had to pay for it, but thank you, Jesus. I went in with my watch. I needed a new band. And I went, and I used to buy them over here in Duncanville. They said, "No, preacher, you got to go over to North Dallas." So I went to North Dallas. And I showed them. They said, "We don't have one. We got to send off to New York." They went to New York, brought it back. I went pick it up Friday, and I said, "That don't look right. That don't fit." They took it back. They said, we're embarrassed. We're sorry. We're not going to charge you a dime. We're going to give it to you. And your wife's watch, we're going to let that go too. Come on. I said, devil, you may try, but you can't win. You may try to come on, but I'm going to keep praising God. I'm going to keep worshiping. I'm going to keep putting praising the devil under my feet. Come on, I'm telling somebody today, you need to put the devil under your feet. It's not time to go down. It's time to go. It's not time to go under. It's time to go. Lord, I feel the Holy Ghost. I feel the joy of the Lord. Come on. Shake five people's hands. Greet one another. We're so glad y'all are here. Two people, we're glad you're here. Come on, thank yourself happy. Be up. Praise Him. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, somebody shout yes. Woo! All right. Bless you. You may be seated. I turn your attention to the screen. These are your morning announcements.
We're going to do that. We're going to go surprise interview some of them. So let's go check it out. What's your name and what do you do for the music department?
My name is Tony Castillo and I sing soprano.
Hi, I'm Becky Carazales and I do the chorale music.
Hi, I'm Tyler Oliver and I do whatever they tell me to.
I'm Tolina Marlin and I play and sing for the youth band.
My name is James. I play the drums and I sing a little bit.
My name is Christian Castillo and I play guitar.
And Tim Pantages and I, of course, play the piano, as you see here.
This thing here.
This thingamabob here.
My name is Josiah Fernandez and I play bass for the Exchange.
How long have you played?
I've been playing the drums since I was 18 years old. I'm now 32.
That's 14 years?
Too hard to count.
Too long.
Not long enough.
What's that
like? Like
5 years?
I started piano whenever I was 6.
How much would you say is God-given talent versus how much you had to practice?
That's not a fair question. That's not a fair question.
40% God-given talent and 60% practice. Because I believe that there's no substitute for hard work. You can be the most talented person in the world, but if you don't practice and master your craft, you won't be very good.
100% God-given talent and 100% practice.
Good answer. What's your favorite hymnal?
Favorite hymnal? That's a tough choice.
The Old Rugged Cross.
I'll Fly Away.
What's your least favorite hymnal?
I'll Fly Away.
I like Nothing But the Blood. That's good too.
What's your least favorite hymn? Don't answer that question.
Yeah, let's not.
Can I say Hillsong? Is my least favorite hymn?
That's going to be my next question. My next question was Hillsong or Bethel?
Oh, I'll plead the fifth on that one.
Gospel music.
Neither.
Can I pick neither?
Yes, you can.
Hillsong.
Hillsong or Bethel?
I'm more of a Jesus culture kind of man myself.
I'm a gospel music person, but Bethel, I suppose.
Thanks, guys. Well, there it is, everybody. We hope you enjoyed that. We hope you learned something from some of our music department. Make sure you thank them. They do a lot of hard work. It's a lot of practice involved, and they have a big responsibility of setting the mood and everything from the beginning of service. So be sure to thank our music department and enjoy the rest of the service. Thank you.
Somebody shout yes. Now next Sunday, I will be seated.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Dallas First Church. If this is your first time visiting, we are so happy that you chose to be with us this morning. If this is your second, third, fourth, or you've been coming here for like 5 years, welcome back. These are your morning announcements, so listen up, pay attention. It's going to be some great information.
What are you turning to? Open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you. None like you. Into the dark.
Reminder for all the ladies. Coming up April 27th and 28th in Frisco, Texas at the Embassy Suites is the North Texas District Ladies Joy Conference. If you want to be a part of this event, they have extended the registration deadline till April 14th. It's $45. At the door, it goes up to $60. So if you want to get a cheap ticket, then register today. If you want any more information or details, you can search Joy Conference at www.eventbrite.com.
Church, this Saturday is our weekly outreach. Now, this week is going to be a little bit different because we are in preparation for Easter Sunday. So it starts at 10 o'clock. We're going to have a free breakfast for whoever wants to come out and help. And then we're going to go out into the community and just invite as many people as possible for Easter Sunday. Now, the following day, Easter Sunday, we are going to start at 10:30, okay? So we're not going to have any Sunday school classes. We're going to go straight into Easter service. It's going to start out with music, go into the Word, and afterwards we're going to have an incredible Easter egg hunt for all the children. You do not want to miss it. Bring as many family members, as many friends. If you don't have any friends, make some friends. If you don't have any family members, look at the family tree. Whatever you got to do, bring somebody with you. It's going to be awesome, and you don't want to miss it. We'd love to see you there.
Church, if you need any more information about any of these announcements, you can see our weekly Sunday bulletins. You can check out our website at www.dallasfirstchurch.com, and you can check out our social media on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at Dallas First Church.
Church, don't miss it.
Enjoy the rest of your Sunday in service.
I'm going to give them a little time. We planned it that way. Y'all don't believe me, do you? Let's give it up for all of those people that work in our media. They do all that. Wow, outstanding. You have to watch them. But good to see everybody in church. Now, before they come back with more praise singing, I want to invite, make sure everybody's inviting someone to church with you next Sunday. Next Sunday's Easter Sunday. I want us to be jam-packed in here. In our other meeting places, they're doing the same thing. Other churches, but let's pack this thing out. I want standing room only. That was a weak, weak clap right then. Let's get everybody that we can come into the house of God. Wow. I mean, I was everywhere I go, whatever place of business, I'm telling everybody. I don't even tell them I'm pastor. I just go and tell them. I want to tell y'all about the most turned on church anywhere. I mean, when you come in, they got their hands in the air. They got their mouths open. Their eyes are big. And it's all for Jesus. And they look at me like, really? And then I got these cards. I mean, we got postcards. We got invite cards. Everybody in the church ought to be picking these up. I try to give away 5 a day. And I always carry extra because I wind up giving out more. People want to hear about it. So take these cards, pick them up, mail them out, hand them out, talk about it. Everybody shout, talk about it.
Talk about it.
Shout, talk about it.
Talk about it.
Y'all shout, talk about it.
Talk about it.
You three amigos say, talk about it. Oh, y'all can say it louder than that. All of y'all shout, talk about it. I want you talking about it at school. Talk about it on the job. Talk about it in the neighborhood. Wherever you're shopping, let's build our church. God is waiting on us to go into the highways and the byways. Come on, I want the buses overflowing next Sunday. We got a big egg hunt. Somebody shout, yeah. So I want you to pick these up during the offering, after church. I want them all gone, all right? That was weak. All right? Are y'all ready? Let's go.
Somebody say, yeah. Between the pages of an old family Bible, I saw dates of birth, deaths, and old revival. I came across a page written with a feeble hand. Said, this is my last request. These are my funeral plans. When I die, let me die speaking tongues. Let it ring in my ears, all this song I've sung. Lord, give me the strength to praise you. Speak your name one more time. Let your angels carry me over to the other side. Oh, Lord, I've lived a long life. My race has nearly run. Can't wait to leave here. I got nothing left undone. I got everything in order. Tell my children not to cry, 'cause I've left them a roadmap. They can meet me in the by and by. Me when I'm gone, they can shout all around my graveside, this ain't my final home.
When I die, let me die speaking in tongues. Let it ring in my ears, all them songs I've sung. Lord, give me the strength to praise you, speak your name one more time. Let your angels carry me over to the other side.
Don't tell my friend and neighbor not to cry for me, 'cause I'm gonna live forever. I've finally been set free. Tell them not to mourn or to miss me when I'm gone. Let me shout all around my graveside, this ain't my final home.
'Cause when I die, let me die speaking in tongues. Let it ring in my ears, all the songs I've sung. Lord, give me the strength to praise you, speak your name one more time. Let your angels carry me over to the other side.
Lord, give me the strength to praise you,
speak your name one more time. Let your angels carry me over to the other side.
Don't tell my friends and neighbors not to cry for me. Well, I'm gonna live forever. I finally been set free. Tell them not to mourn or to miss me when I'm gone. They can shout all around my graveside, this ain't my final home.
When I die, let me die speaking in tongues. all of them songs I sung. Lord, give me strength to praise you. Speak your name one more time. Let your angels carry me on to the other side.
Lord, give me strength to praise you.
Speak your name one more time. Let your angels carry me on to the other side.
Yeah. Come on, put your hands together and magnify. Woo! Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Woo! Grab your can. I want you to make your way back to your seat. We're just getting warmed up. We're going to sing some more. Uh-huh. We're going to sing some more. Sometimes things are not always like we think they are. And as Brother Foster was saying, lost his washing machine, washes, dishwasher. Hey, I tell you, when I was a boy, we had a dishwasher. We had 7 of them. How can you lose a dishwasher when you got 7 of them? Uh-huh. Woo. It's your turn. No, it's your turn. Lost this and lost that and lost this. But I'm going to tell you what. Hey, look what the Lord has done. Sometimes we go through the valley. Sometimes we have a mountain.
All right.
Hallelujah. Listen what it said. Face a mountain that I've never faced before. That's why I'm calling on you, Lord. I know it's been a while, but Lord, please hear my cry. I need you like I never have before. Come on, say it.
Sometimes it takes a mountain. Ooh. Sometimes the troubles
Jesus.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I thought I could control whatever life would throw my way. But this I will admit has brought me to my knees. I need you, Lord, and I'm not ashamed.
Sometimes the troubles seem
A mountain sometimes to help us to trust and believe Him. And there's people here today that you have mountains and you need to learn how to praise your way through them and give your way through them. Giving of your time and your talent and your treasure as you give to God. Hallelujah. Man, I like what I feel in this place. Hallelujah. While you're standing, the ushers are coming through the auditorium right now, and they have our giving envelopes ready. And so if you'll just raise your hands, they will be there to assist you. They're coming down the aisles right now. Just hold your hand up. Many of you have already given online. Many of you have already paid at the kiosk. They are open now, and people are there. And you can give at the kiosk by plastic. Some of you have already passed by the office and left it there. Some send it in the mail. We have boxes in the back. You can leave it there. But we are grateful for your consistent belief in the Word of God that says, bring all the tithe and offerings into the storehouse. Now, while you are preparing that, let's give extra today. We are glad to have Tim Spell and his good wife, Jeannie, here with us today. We're honored that they are here. We're giving. Now, next Sunday's Easter Sunday. We need more eggs. That big egg hunt, we don't want boiled eggs. Because when you say boiled eggs, somebody don't boil them. Somebody's going to get hit. So we want canned eggs. Somebody said, why do you give away? If you're a fisherman, you have to use bait. We're fishers of men. We're just bringing people to Jesus. And we're going to preach We're going to preach about the dark night's over, so watch out. Now, while you're preparing to give, go ahead, get on Facebook, Instagram, whatever, and just check in and let everybody know I'm at Dallas First Church, and you should be too.
That's good. That's good.
All right, I got two. That's good.
That's good.
Oh, I know y'all are either writing or you're on your phone checking in right now. That's good.
Check in.
Wow. Somebody shout, check in.
Check in.
Come on, I want the devil to know I've checked in. I want my flesh to know I've checked in. Lord, have mercy. All right, hold your giving up. In the name of Jesus, Lord, I pray over this, our giving. Bless it into our lives. Bless revival in Jesus' name. Somebody shout amen. Amen. All right, these gentlemen waiting on you. As you come, let's get these invite cards, postcards. Let's hand them out all week long.
Some glad morning when this life is over. My way to a home on God's celestial shore.
Hands together and let's praise.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. You may be seated. What a time we're having here today. Lord, 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 Lord. Now I want to sing a couple more songs here. We ain't no telling what we're going to do before we get out of here. But we're going to have church. We're going to have church. Look at your neighbor and say, we're going to have church. I may have testified about this last time, but we had an epic flood back in August 12th, 13th, 14th, 31 inches of rain in 2 days. That's a lot of rain, a lot of water. Oh, Lord. And I wasn't home when it happened. Jeannie was there. She's with us today. Lost the car. And brand new Mercedes, gone, total. Water over the top of it. And then, of course, my wife, to get out of the situation, drove my truck through 6 feet of water. So now you know the rest of the story. But thank God she made it. So I got home on that Monday night after the flood. I hadn't seen my mother. And over a month, I've been gone all over the country, And so first thing Tuesday morning, I made a point to go see my mother in a nursing home. She's there with Alzheimer's. It's just a long goodbye. And so I walked in. I'll never forget walking into that nursing home on that Tuesday morning, about 8 o'clock in the morning. She's about here at the back of that wall from me where I walked in. She had a little hat on, sitting there in her reclining chairs on wheels. About 20 or 25 of the elderly ladies there. And behind my mother on the wall was a great big boom box, and it was just a blaring. And I walked in and I saw her there, boom box over her head. I'll never forget the song that was on the boom box. It was just blaring. I've got sunshine on a cloudy day. When the night is cold, I've got the month of May. Isn't that a consolation? I guess you say, what can make me feel this way, my girl? Don't act like you don't know it. Hey, Sister Gayle, ain't nothing wrong with the song. Some of you husbands ought to sing My Girl to your sweetheart when you get home.
Amen.
Huh? If there's any consolation, I got the month of May is what the writer said. Can I tell you something? When you're 86 years old and you got 1 foot in Chili Jordan and you listen for the blast of a trumpet in your ears, my girl don't resonate with you. Woo! I said to my mother, do you know we had a flood? She said, no one told me a thing. I said, let's get you out of this room where we can hear ourselves think. No sooner got her away from all that big loud noise, I started quoting the word of the Lord, the Lord's Prayer, the 23rd Psalm. You just start her off. She'll take off on it. Then we started singing these old songs. And then I said, I got to go. Got to go. Let's do one more song. Took my phone there, just like you said a while ago. Check in. I checked in, and I said, let's sing this song. And I videoed my mother and I singing this old song. No lights, no sound system, no keyboard, nothing. Just me and my mother, and began to sing this old song. Late that night, I put it on social media. It went viral. It went viral. Last I checked, close to 500,000 views. No psychedelic lights, no big sound system, no theater, just a mother full of the Holy Ghost. How many of you like to hear the song that me and my mother sang? They're going to help me sing it. Listen to what it said. My heart can sing when I pause to remember that a heartache here is but a stepping stone along the trail that's winding always upward. This troubled world is not my final home. Sing it now. But until then, my heart will go on singing. Yes, until then, with joy I'll carry on until the day. the things of earth will dim and lose their value when we recall, Lord, they're just borrowed for a while, and things of earth that cause my heart to tremble. Said the things of earth will dim and lose their value. Brother Foster, when I was a boy, 4 and 5 years old, things of great value to me then was maybe, never forget the first electric train set I got. Brother, I thought I had won the lottery. Electric train set from Ben Franklin, 5 and 10. Some of you don't know what that is. And then I got a pair of roller skates. I remember my first bicycle with training wheels. These things are great value to me. When I was 5 and 6, not only a bicycle, but training wheels, 5 and 6 years old. Great value. Let me tell you something. If you're 25, and a pair of roller skates is still great value, I want to talk to you after church. No. At different times of our life, things increase or decrease in value. And the older you get, the things of earth will dim and lose their value. My wife and I went through that flood. Everything. Look at your neighbor, say everything.
Everything.
We lost everything. A lot of folks don't know what everything, yes, it's a compound word. Everything from 6 foot down. Things were contaminated. People were helping us clean the house out. Said, you want to keep this? My wife said, throw it away. How about this? Throw it away. How about this? Throw it away. You'd be surprised what you can lose and still keep on going when you realize the things of earth will dim and lose their value. When you recall they're borrowed for a while. So I was in South America, Brazil, and they wanted me to work with a 200 voice choir. Well, they speak Portuguese there. I said, what am I going to do? I don't speak Portuguese. I barely can speak English. So I thought and I thought till I thought. I know what I'll do. I'll find a song like modern praise and worship. It's got five words, and you sing it 500 times. So I've picked out this song that y'all fixing to help me sing. And it simply says, all night long, all night long, all night long, all night long. Look at your neighbor, say, all night long. Anybody here speak Spanish? Toda de noche. Toda de noche. Is that pretty close? Huh? Look at your neighbor, say, toda de noche. Look at your neighbor, say, all night long. Hey, can I tell you something? Anybody can praise the Lord when everything is going good. When you're on top of the world and both feet are dangling off, and every day is a zippity-doo-dah day, Mr. Bluebird is on your shoulder. You just got a raise on the job, and the kid's on the honor roll, and your mother-in-law just left on 3-week vacation. Hey, wait a minute. What about when the tables are turned? What about when you lose? When you can come to the house of God and still say, I think I'm going to praise Jesus all night long, all night long. Yeah. Unison. All night long.
All night long. All night long.
Yeah, yeah.
All night long.
Say it now.
All night long.
I think I'm going to pray Jesus.
I think I'm going to pray Jesus. All night long.
Go there, baby. They enjoyed looking very good in the neighborhood. Paul said, I know God is true. Let me tell you what I'm gonna do. You know, I
think I'm gonna praise Jesus all night.
You got trouble in your way.
Yeah.
You got problems every day. Another heartache around the bend. Lord, it looks like it's never gonna end. I've got good news for you. Let me tell you what I'm gonna do. You know
I think I'm gonna praise Jesus all night.
Say,
I'm gonna praise him anyway.
It doesn't matter what the demons say.
I'm gonna praise him anyway.
It doesn't matter what the hypocrites say.
I'm gonna praise him anyway.
It doesn't matter what the demons say.
I'm gonna praise him anyway.
Say, I'm gonna praise him anyway. Say it again.
I'm gonna praise him. All night long.
on, somebody.
Oh, yeah.
You ain't letting nobody.
Nobody.
Woo. Uh-huh. Yeah. Yeah. Somebody said, boy, if you'd have sung that verse one more time, I think I'd have come out of my pews. Uh-huh. You got trouble in your way. You got problems every day.
Every day.
Another heartache around the bend. Lord, it looks like you're never gonna end. I got good news for you. Let me tell you what I'm gonna do. You know, I think I'm gonna praise Jesus all night long. Your neighbor say we're having church. Woo! Hello. Uh-huh. Just warming up. You may be seated. Hey, somebody said when I get to heaven, I'm gonna shout all over the streets of gold. I am too, but I'm gonna start in Dallas, Texas, on the carpet at First Pentecostal Church on a Sunday morning. Y'all stay where you are. I want y'all to help me sing a song, okay? Don't you love surprises? Now listen, we in Texas. Don't tell me we're not.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Woo!
And someone wrote a song, said, if you're going to play in Texas, you got to have a fiddle in the band. Well, the closest we can come to it is a guitar Stratocaster. Fender Stratocaster. It's got strings, and we got a bass guitar. Uh-huh. But I want to do a country song style.
Can I?
Someone put on social media, said, Southern gospel singer.
Yeah.
Well, I'm Southern and I'm gospel.
Woo!
And I'm a singer. You got it right. Southern gospel. Whew. Is any other kind? Mm-hmm. So I'm going to take it on back. When I get to the chorus, y'all just find your place in there. Key of F, Brother Tim. I have no mansion, no earthly kingdom, but my cabin will do till I get home. My mansion yonder on the hills of glory. I hope my mansion sits near the throne. So it doesn't matter who lives around. just across the Golden Avenue. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Now, I got to thinking about that, where it said, it doesn't matter who lives around me. Look at your neighbor and say, are you kidding me? Brother Foster, you and I know people who can't even go to the same church together. And when they get there, they can't sit across the aisle from one another. Did you hear what the song says? It doesn't matter who lives around me. If you make it to heaven, you ought to be a pretty good neighbor. Woo! Now, I tell you what. It seems like I was just here a few weeks ago. And these praise and worship singers, I'm going to tell you what, they're just incredible. The presentation you gave, musicians. The musicians, give them a big hand. Come on. Yeah. So I've got a sermon that takes an hour and a half to preach. God bless both of y'all. But I ain't gonna preach it. I'm gonna take an hour and a half sermon and turn it into 15 minutes. Is that all right? Don't start counting yet though. I'll tell you when to start counting. I am so happy to be here once again. And the first time that my wife is here, I don't know where she is. She's here somewhere. There she is, right back there. Wave your hand, Jeannie. My, my, my. So we're delighted. I like the title, the name is Dallas First Church. First Church. This is Dallas First Church. And this is just an awesome place. And to be with all the wonderful saints of God. I love the saints of God. And I love my good friends, Brother and Sister Foster. These are incredible people. Can I tell you something? When I was a boy, we had milk cows. We had Guernsey cows, Jersey cows, Holstein cows. We had a Holstein cow give about almost 11 gallons of milk a day. Uh-huh. And we'd make that butter. Anybody ever make butter from fresh cow milk? Yeah. And then sometimes we'd just take the milk, put it in that big mouth, strain it, you know, put it in that big mouth jar, and put a lid on it, put it in an ice box. And come back a couple hours, and guess what? Cream done rose to the top. That's why we call it the cream of the crop. You don't have to open the ice box and say, come on, cream, rise. Would you please rise? No, it comes to the top, whether you're looking at it or not. When you come to the First Pentecostal Church of Dallas, ain't nobody got to say, come on, lift up your hands. Come on, lift up your voice. You do it because that's what you do. I better get my Bible. I'm going to leave all my notes right there so I won't go. You may be seated. Would you please come take my Bible right here? Put both hands on it. Rub it real good. Just put your hands all over the top. Take it to your brother and make him do the same thing. Just give it to my good friends right here. Just let them touch it. Touch it real good. Both hands. There you go. Both hands. Now bring it back to me. See this Bible? It's a genuine leather. Now, I've sold literally thousands, and tens of thousands of these Bibles. At one time, we had the South's largest bookstores, my father and I. So literally tens of, sometimes you get a Bible that says genuine bonded leather. This ain't bonded. This is one piece. And it's leather on the inside. I want you to feel what a genuine leather. And you get that genuine leather Bible, and you open it up for the first time, lay it out on the counter, and it's got that brand new smell to it. And then it got a certificate of authentication inside it. It says, you don't need to do anything to this Bible to preserve the leather. The natural oils from your hands will preserve this leather. I know what some of you are thinking right now. My Bible is tearing up. Yeah, because you ought to get it out and put your hands on it sometime. Somebody say yeah. Well, so much for the announcements. So you just thought I wanted you to touch my Bible. No. I wanted you to preserve and put some life to my Bible. So the oil's from your hand and your hand and your hand. Our hands have handled the Word of God. I can't start calling names. All these musicians, all these singers. God bless each and one of you. But to the wonderful pastor, Brother Tom Foster, Sister Gayla Foster, these incredible people, wonderful friends, and I thank God for good people in my life. You can't make it by yourself. If you see a turtle on top of a telephone pole, you know he didn't get there by himself. Somebody had to help him. Anyway, I hope I haven't forgot anything. I want to read one verse of scripture in the book of Hebrews. Hebrews chapter 12. Now, stacks of Bibles, and I lost a lot of Bibles in the flood. I had stacks of Bibles, and if you'd looked at my Bibles from way back in the 60s and 70s, those Bibles are tattered and torn, and especially around the book of Hebrews, it's just the pages all coming out, because I spent a lot of time in the book of Hebrews. Chapter number 12, verse number 18. For ye are not come unto the mount that might be touched, and that burned with fire, nor into blackness and darkness and tempest, and the sound of a trumpet and the voice of words, which voice they that heard entreated that the word should not be spoken to them any more. For they could not endure that which was commanded. And if so much as a beast touch the mountain, it shall be stoned, or thrust through with a dart. And so terrible was the sight that Moses said, I exceedingly fear and quake. But ye are coming to Mount Zion, and unto the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, to an innumerable company of angels, to the general assembly and church of the firstborn, which are written in heaven, and to God the judge of all, and to the spirits of just men made perfect, and to Jesus, the mediator of the new covenant, and to the blood of sprinkling that speaketh better things than that of Abel. God bless you in Jesus' name. Now, I'm going to put a marker right there and close it in case I need to go back to it. Look at your neighbor, say amen. I hope I can remember everything without my notes. I find myself forgetting things. And I heard about the man that's in the nursing home. He hadn't been there just a few days, and he began to notice one of the ladies there and have special feelings for her and making eyes at her. Finally, that evening, one evening at supper, he walked up to her and asked her if she would marry him. And all night long, he tossed and turned because he could not remember if she said yes or no. And could not sleep all night long. Could not remember. And so he couldn't wait to get to the cafeteria the next morning. And he was the first one in there, waiting for her to come. Finally, after a while, she made her grand entrance into the cafeteria. He walked up to her and said, "I am so embarrassed. I feel so bad." He said, "I could not sleep all night long." He said, "Yesterday, I asked you if you would marry me, but I couldn't remember if you said yes or no." She said, "I knew someone had asked me, but I couldn't remember who it was." I hope I can remember this. The book of Hebrews is a book of comparisons. It is written to show the superiority of Christianity over Judaism. The key word to the book of Hebrews is the word better. Look at your neighbor, say better. It is a book of comparisons. It's the only epistle in the New Testament that starts out without salutations. It starts out with the central theme of the universe. God, who at sundry times and in divers manners spake in times past unto the fathers by the prophets. Notice the comparison in the verse number 2. Hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, Jesus Christ, whom he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the worlds. Verse number 4, who being the brightness of his glory. You got to get it right nowadays. They'll throw it up on the board. Who being the brightness of his glory and the express image of his person, and upholding all things by the word of his power, when he had by himself purged our sins, sat down on the right hand of the majesty on high. Notice the next verse is another comparison. Being made so much, there's a key word, better. Being made so much better than the angels, as he hath by inheritance obtained a more excellent name than they. I'm glad I know the name of Jesus. Anybody glad you know the name of Jesus? The second chapter starts off with another comparison. Therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip. For if the word spoken by angels was steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience received a just recompense of reward, how shall we escape if we neglect so great a salvation? This is a great salvation. This is a great salvation. I saw people shouting and running the aisles a while ago. You know why? Because they know this is a great salvation. You didn't just win the lottery. No, no. The Dallas Cowboys just didn't win the Super Bowl. No. The Dallas Mavericks didn't win the NBA title. No, no, no. I'll tell you why you're shouting. Because this is a great salvation. And this is a great church. And this is a great house. Everything I know about God is great. Oh, come on, put your hands together and magnify Him. If you know God is great, clap your hands to the Lord. So, when you get to the 12th chapter of the book of Hebrews, it picks up again on the comparison. For ye are not coming to a mount that might be touched. Let's talk about Mount Sinai. Great is Mount Sinai, sublime in solitude, robed in clouds, shrouded in smoke, illuminated with fire, wherewith heaven's earthquake and thunders rumbling amidst the crags and the gorges, and lightnings flashing in zigzag patterns across the darkened clouds. The law was given, commandments that are not ghostly whispers of a dead century, but commandments that are just as authoritative today as when their silence, their proclamation broke the age-long silence of the desert. It said, you are not coming to Mount Sinai, unto a mount that might be touched, or that burned with fire, sound of a trumpet, the voice of words. And so dreadful was the sight that even Moses said, I exceedingly fear and quake. But he said, this is what you have come unto. And this is what I want to preach to you. You can start counting your time now, 15 minutes. But ye are come unto Mount Zion, city of the living God. No, no, you didn't get it. He's alive. They put him in a borrowed tomb. You know why they put Jesus in a borrowed tomb? What's the use buying it? All I need is for 72 hours. The best place for a resurrection is a graveyard. He's alive. Look at your neighbor and say, he's alive. Next Sunday is Resurrection Sunday. Oh yeah, he rose up on Easter Sunday. The very flowers of the field and the trees of the forest that flourished during the balmy days of spring and finally falling away at the blast of winter's chilling breath. After lying silently in their snow-covered graves of time, comes forth from their tombs of confinement with an inaudible shout, filling the atmosphere with their fragrance, echoing, re-echoing over the hills and through the valleys, declaring that the winter is past and the time of the singing of birds is come. At the going down of the evening sun, the plowman stalks wearily towards home. The cattle come in from the pasture and linger about the barnyard. The fowls with stretched out necks seek out their resting place for the night. Evening bell is heard and darkness falls, leaving nothing but the flickering candle from an unshaded window in the distance to tell that last that life is still there. But then the silence is broken, the midnight hour, the cock crowing, the rising of the morning star precedes the breaking of the day. And at the first streak of dawn, life begins to be manifest. And as the sun bursts forth from the womb of the morning, it breaks the power of slumber, bringing to life its yawning millions from the regions of the solitudes of the night to the activities of the day. All of this speaks incessantly that there must be a resurrection. If there be no resurrection, our faith is vain. I'm glad I've got the spirit of the resurrection in me today. At Bethlehem, he was God with us. At Calvary, he was God for us. At Pentecost, he is God in us. I got the resurrection when I got the Holy Ghost. Brother Foster, I'm not talking about a mount that might be touched. I'm not talking about Mount Sinai. I'm talking about Mount Zion, the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, the heavenly Jerusalem. Hey, can I just tell you something? Have you ever been to Jerusalem? I ain't either, but I'm in there this morning. But I'm there this morning. I'm here. I'm in the heavenly Jerusalem. When you walk through those double doors, you came into the heavenly Jerusalem. When you go on the job tomorrow, you take the heavenly Jerusalem with you. Well, we've come unto Mount Zion, city of the living God. The Russians said we went to the moon. We looked for God. We couldn't find him. No, you can't find him because God is a spirit. And you can go further than the moon. You're still not going to find him because God is a spirit. But it's like the old man that came up to the little boy on the cloudy day, and he was flying his kite. And he said, "Sonny, what are you doing?" "I'm flying my kite," said the little boy. And the old man looked up and said, "I can't see it. How do you know it's up there?" He said, "The reason why I know it's up there, because every time I pull on this string, I feel something on the other side. Hey, I can't see God, but I can feel him. And when I lift my hand, I can feel him in my hands. I feel him in my feet. I feel him in my heart. I feel him all over me." Somebody say, "Yeah." Now watch that carefully. Coming to Mount Zion, city of the living God, heavenly Jerusalem, to an innumerable company of angels. Lift your hand up like this. Shake your hand like that. You just shook hands with an angel. That word says innumerable. That means you can't count them. Innumerable company of angels. To the General Assembly and Church of the Firstborn. I like the first church because we're firstborn. We belong to the Church of the Firstborn. That's why we're first church. Hey, I said we belong to the Church of the Firstborn. Somebody said, "Well, when did you join the church?" I didn't join. I was born. Well, I got news for you. I shook the preacher's hand and signed the church roll. So I'm ready to go. No. Hey, you can write your name on a barn door and shake a mule's tail. That don't make you a farmer. I didn't join this church, but I came to an altar and I repented of my sins. And I went down in water in the grave. And when I came up, I was a new creature. I'm going to tell you what, some of you look as nervous as a termite in a yo-yo. Hey, oh, well, I accepted the Lord. No, when I got the Holy Ghost, I accepted him. But when I got the Holy Ghost, I spake in tongues. Brother Foster, I got a nice pair of Johnson & Murphy shoes on right here. Those things can really take a shine, too. There's people in the Houston airport know me by name because I get my shoes shine. Preacher needs his shoes shine. You got one or two things. You better have a good sermon or you better have a good shoe shine. It don't hurt to have both. I bought them shoes on sale at the what they call the outlet. Don't ever pay full price for something when you can get it for a better price. And when I bought them shoes, I didn't go up to the clerk and say, "You know, I don't like the tongues on them shoes. Can I have a pair of shoes without tongues?" No, no, no. When I bought these shoes, the tongues came with them. When I got the Holy Ghost, the tongues came with them. When you get the Holy Ghost, it says they heard them speak with tongues. I wonder if anybody's apostolic today. I wonder if we got any apostolics here today. I wonder if we got any Pentecostal apostolics. So my great-grandmother, Mary Pettigo, was a shouting Methodist. I'm talking about what we're coming to. I'm still in my text. We've come into Mount Zion, city of the living God, heavenly Jerusalem, innumerable company of angels, general assembly, church of the firstborn, which are written in heaven. Come on, put your hand up here and say, written in heaven, written in heaven, written in heaven. My name may not go down in who's who, but my name is written. So my great-grandmother, Mary Pettigo, was a shouting Methodist. Thank God, God loves the Methodists. God loves the Baptists. God loves the Catholics. Somebody said, can a Catholic get the Holy Ghost? I hope so. Can a Methodist get the Holy Ghost? I hope so. My great-grandmother was a shouting Methodist. But she heard about that Brush Harbor meeting, and she hitched up old Nellie to the buggy. 10 boys and one girl. And they went down to that Brush Harbor meeting in the early 1900s and heard the gospel message. And God filled her with the Holy Ghost. This is what I've been looking for, she said. And she went back to the Methodist church, and they pulled her coattail, said, Mary, you can't act that way over here. So she went back down to the Holy Roller church. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm a holy roller. Come on, don't be ashamed. I'm a holy roller. Some folks call us holy rollers, and I guess it's true. But if they knew what we were rolling about, they'd be rolling too. So guess what? She went back down to the Holy Roller church. And after a few weeks at the Holy Roller church, the deacon of the Methodist church came and knocked on my great-grandmother Mary Pettigo's door. Got to talk to you, Mary. The pastor sent me to tell you that if you keep on going down to them holy rollers, we're going to have to take your name off the church roll. You know what my great-grandmother Mary Pettigo did? Started shouting all over the living room, speaking in tongues. And when she finally got her composure, she looked at the deacon and said, you go tell the pastor he don't have a pencil with an eraser long enough to take my name off of heaven's roll. I remember the day when God took the pen of salvation and dipped it in the ink of redemption and inscribed my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. I wonder if anybody's got the Holy Ghost here today. Woo! I left my phone. I don't know what time it is, but I know some. I can look at some of you, and I know it's time to go. Let me hear you say yeah. Lord, have mercy. So, we're coming to the General Assembly, Church of the First One, which are written in heaven. And to God, the judge of all. Uh-oh. Say, uh-oh. See, here's what the problem is, Pastor. Some folks think they're the judge. No, it says God. I'm talking about something we've come into. Yeah. We've come into God, the judge of all. Yeah. Somebody said, what's the difference between God and man? God don't think he's man, that's what. I told my wife the other day, I said, I'm not going to play gods concerning so-and-so. I'm not going to damn them to hell. And I'm not going to put them in heaven because I don't have a heaven to send them to. I don't have a hell to send them to. I'm going to put them in the hands of God because he's God. He's their judge. I'm not going to give up on them. I'm going to keep on praying. I'm going to keep on pushing. I'm going to keep on pulling. I'm going to keep on pushing. And I'm going to keep on pulling. You know why? Because I'm a pusher. The reason why I preach is because I'm a pusher. I want to push you all the way to heaven. I want to pull you from the flames. That's why we call it a pulpit, because we pull people from the pit. And we keep on pulling, and we keep on pushing. You know why? Because you don't want to go to hell, and your daughter don't want to die of a drug addiction, and your son don't want to die an alcoholic. That's why we keep on pushing, and we keep on pulling, and we keep on preaching, and we keep on praying. Because God is the judge of all. And to the spirits of just men made perfect. I'm almost done in case you're counting time. The next one says, and to Jesus. And to Jesus, the mediator of the new covenant. Somebody said, well, that's, you got the judge, you got God, and you got Jesus, the mediator. That's two. No, that ain't two. It's just one. Say, just one. Just one. The judge is the one who sits behind the desk with the black robe. He got the gavel. The mediator is the one who sits next to your hide, trying to plead your cause. The good news this morning, First Pentecostal, is my judge is my advocate. My judge is my go-between. My judge is the one that's going to plead my cause. Shout yeah! Just one? Yeah, just one. Jesus is not Jehovah Jr. He's not a second person. No, no, no. He's the first, and he's the last. He's the Alpha. He's the Omega. He's the beginning. He's the end. He's the root of David and the offspring of David. Which is, which was, which is to come, the Almighty. Woo! Jesus, the maker of the universe, as man for man was made a curse. The claims of law which he had made, unto the utmost he paid. His holy fingers formed the bow, which grew the thorns that pierced his brow. The nails that pierced his hands were mined, in secret places he designed. He grew the forest whence there sprung the tree on which his body hung. He died upon a cross of wood, yet he made the hill on which it stood. The sun that hid from him its face by his decree was poised in space. And the sky that darkened o'er his head by him above the earth was spread. The tomb in which his form was laid was hewn in rocks that his hands had made. And the spear that pierced his precious side was tempered in the fires of God. The throne on which he now appears was his from everlasting years. But a new glory crowns his brow, and every knee to him shall bow. Jesus is the true God. Jesus is the only God. Jesus is the great I am. Jesus is the Father. Jesus is the Son. Jesus is the Holy Ghost. And all these three are one. Oh my God. So here it is. It's something we've come into. Jesus, the mediator of the new covenant. And here I'm closing. And to the blood. And to the blood. Of sprinkling. That speaketh better things. There's your key word. Better. Better things than that of Abel. And what I've said all that to tell you this. This is something you have come up to. All right. You've come unto this. Now, y'all sang a song earlier. I like it. I love all the chord progressions in it. It's snappy. It's good. You can really jive to it. But it said something, I'm chasing God. Something like that, right? Guess what? He ain't running from you. I like the song. I'm going to sing it. Because I'm chasing him too. But I got news for you. He ain't running from you. Some of you are holding on to the back of the pew right now so you won't have to chase in this altar. There's no virtue on the back of that pew. Everything I've been telling you about is, it's here. We have come unto. Look at your neighbor and say, we have come unto. The Holy Ghost is here. God is here. Jesus is here. The mediator is here. The blood of sprinkling is here. So he said, for we have not a high priest, same book, Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12. For we have not an high priest which cannot be touched with the feeling of our infirmities. Anybody got any infirmities here today? but was in all points tempted like as we are, yet without sin. Therefore, let us come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. I'm chasing God because I want Him. But not just because I want Him, because I need Him. I wonder if anybody has got a need today. If you don't have a need, this is not for you. Laodicea said, I ain't need nothing. But they really did need it. Look at your neighbor and say, I just don't just want God, but I need Him. This grace is not just for those who want it. It's for those who need it. This grace is not for the self-righteous. It's for those who are down and out. It's for those who feel like, I can't do it. I can't do this on my own. I've messed up. I made a fine mess of things. But God, You told me in Your word that Your grace would be there in the time of my need. Now, in my hand, I have a CD. I don't have any for sale today because the flood got them all. Everything I had, I think I sold last time I was here. And I haven't had the order, new order come in yet. I got one CD, and I want to give this away. I want to give this CD. Who would like this? Somebody, raise your hand. See, there you go. You see, about 50 hands went up, but one man said, I don't only want it, I'm going to go get it. See, you got to do more than just want it. You got to come get it. The Holy Ghost is for those who want it, but it's for those who need it. And if you really need God, you'll say, I'm coming to get it. I'm not just going to say me too, but I'm coming up to get it right now. I wonder if there's anybody here who says, that's what I want. I raise my hand, I need God, but I'm coming and I'm going to get what I need. I'm not just going to raise my hand, I'm coming and I'm going to get it. Because it's here, it's here, it's here, it's here, right now, right now, right now, right now. In the name of Jesus, there's power to set you free. In the name of Jesus, there's power to heal your sick body. In the name of Jesus, there's power to transform you. There's power to heal you. There's power to lift you up out of the miry clay. There's power over the enemy. There's power all over this building. I want you to lift up your voice. Lift up your hands all over this building. When you come to this altar, I want you to pray and believe God that you didn't come up here just because you want something. You come up here because you need Him. You got to cry from the very depths of your soul. I need Thee. I need it. I need it. I need it. I need God. I need God. Brother Foster, I don't just want Him. I need Him. There are people in this altar that need God. There's people here that need God. I want Him, but I need Him as well. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. I want you to reach over and pray with somebody next to you. All over this building, if you'll step out from where you are, come as close as you can. God's fixing to work miracles in this altar. God's fixing to pour out the Holy Ghost in this altar. In the name of Jesus.